Very good morning, everyone. I will start with a very personal story of mine, which happened quite some time ago, about 8 years. We were working in the rural areas of Bangladesh, trying to identify the sense of purpose and the aim of life of children and youths in the rural area. So we were having FGDs with these youths and children in the educational institutions. And also, apart from educational institutions, the youths not studying or not in employment or not trained. We also had discussions with teachers, with community peoples, trying to understand what their visions is for the future. In majority of the cases, we found on the degradation of moral values in our society. The community and the youths have this moral graciousness and how this honesty and sincerity were prominent within the youths and the teenagers. And we wanted to find out more, and later on we summed up respecting elders, respecting youngers, respecting nature and environment, respecting diversity, and respecting your own country. So all these respects seems a very good recipe for bringing the society forward and also making our youth more productive. So I want to dig in more and trying to find out the root causes. So I use the golden question, why, for all the root causes that the people forwarded to me. And I was saying why that happened and what caused it. You know, it went on for quite some time, almost like two and a half hours. And I, to my surprise, these people were enjoying the entire demystifications and understanding the complex degradation process in the society. That was pretty good. At the end, it all bogged down that our fascination and our love for lying and cheating with others is the primary cause. That was pretty heavy, and it was very abstract. I don't know what to do. I came back to Dhaka and was trying to develop a program that through the program we can again revive our old moral values again. But it was difficult. It was difficult to make people incline back again in honesty and trustworthiness. It's not easy. Making people speaking the truth is probably one of the dreams that everybody had in the early societies, but they couldn't achieve much. I was thinking about something, how to measure lie. When people speak lies, how to measure that? And obviously, I was not thinking about setting up a truth commission or developing a lie detector, but something like we have read in the early days. Yes, Pinocchio. Pinocchio is a character developed by an Italian writer, and we all know Pinocchio's tendency of lying, which causes his nose to grow. What a fascinating solution for a very complex problem. But I really wanted that, but it was a fiction. So I started working on the program that I was trying to build, but I later on almost got frustrated and sort of at the verge of giving it up. When one of the headmasters of the school that we had FGD rang me up and said, "What are you doing about the program?" And I said, it's very challenging and I'm not sure if I can really make some program out of it. And let me see. So this headmaster gave me an encouragement. And he said, I saw your passion when you were doing this drill during the FGD. And I know if somebody can do something, it's you. So please try it. So I started to look into the entire scenario from a different perspective, giving it a fresh look, and developed a small questionnaire, which I wanted to sort of measure how much a kid lies in a week. So we had a very simple daily activity questions, like had they washed their hands when they were having dinner last night? Did they do their homework all by themselves? Or did they copy it from their friend? So similar kind of questions. And the teacher, and we also did cross-checking with their families and their peers to see if they're speaking the truth. The teacher maintained a scorecard. And at the end of a month, obviously a few students scored higher and termed as more truthful. This went on for 3 months. And at the end of 3 months, I received a call from this headmaster again, saying that they have found 3 top scorers. And now what to do? I said, that's wonderful news. And let's organize a celebration, an event, and where we can honor these students. We set a date, and I bought a few gifts, very small gifts, like pens, wall clocks, backpack, water bottles, books, t-shirts. And that stipulated day, I went to this school. But to my surprise, I found the school campus crowded with local people. I was slightly annoyed because I thought it must be a market day, or it could be a football game happening in the same campus. And how could the teacher organize this event in the same campus in a crowded place like this? So I rolled down my car window and I asked an old man, what's going on? I froze when the old man said, the school has found the Alameen, meaning the most truthful and most trusted person. And there were dignitaries also, and there were a whole crowd. It was such a large crowd, the entire village was there. Men, women, young boys and girls, even toddlers. It was like a festival. There were dignitaries and elites who talked a little, gave a speech to this entire audience. And I asked the top scorer from class 6 to say something. And what he said, I still remember those golden words, that adults probably have a reason to lie. But students like us have no true reasons. And if a student rigorously follows truthfulness in the school for 10 years, they will find it hard to lie after that practice. That was my take from the entire program. And that's what gave me the motivation to work on this program. So that was huge for me. I never imagined this program can be so large and has an impact so deep. Because later on I found every children in the school are competing to become Alameen the next. Every family is encouraging their children to become a role model. And the families are also practicing an honest life. So I would conclude here that social transformation does not require a grand, elaborate program. It can be a little encouragement, a commitment, a passion, which can change the entire world. I saw these children, we call them star children, who are changing and transforming the community like a Midas touch. Changing a rusted iron into gold. So we want to change the world and transform this world with honest and sincere people in the entire community. Thank you so much.